Welcome to How to Yugioh. Let's explain board breakers. So, board breakers, what are they? Board breakers are cards that are specifically designed to break boards that your opponent makes. So, for example, when your opponent makes a board with multiple monsters that have negation effects on them, with a multiple set back row that you've seen has, you know, negation on them as well, board breakers would allow you to break set established board and allowing the game to continue in a healthy sort of a way. So it's they help in giving that interaction, because the problem of making a very big board is that really, it doesn't allow player to interact. There's no that two-player interaction. As you can recall, a duel involves two people. So if there's no interaction with your opponent, then it's not really a duel now, is it? So hence why we have board breakers. Now, board breakers have been seeing an increased usage as of late, especially in our meta game. But it wasn't always the case. I mean, when we first had our board breaker, which was Raigeki, it was quite strong at the time because we really couldn't summon a lot of monsters during that time. So a spell that allowed you to destroy all monsters your opponent controls, that was quite strong. And that spell is called Raigeki. Now, over the years, obviously, we've gotten some other board-breaking cards, but it's really, you know, we got Lightning Vortex, however, that never saw competitive play because you need to discard a card to destroy all face-up monsters. Then we have Special Hurricane, where you discard a card, destroy all special summon monsters. Again, that's not seen competitive play, you know, somewhat, yeah, it just didn't see it. Raigeki, I think, is the only card still to this day as well, we can say that it's seen competitive play to the point that it got limited to one. Now, why am I bringing this topic up of Raigeki and board breakers? Well, you know, power creep is a thing. You know, Konami as a business, as a company, has always been about promoting themselves and releasing cards to get hype, you know what I mean? Get people excited to play the game, release the next broken-ass monster, you know what I'm talking about, yeah? And that involves, like, just releasing some bullshit, some nonsense, right? And yeah, and they have released, obviously, hand traps, again, to, you know, to sort of balance the situation, but they don't really target the key problem of the game. Anyways, this video is not talking about the key problem of the game. It's just talk about board breakers and how I feel they're helping. Now, ever since Konami has taken this stance to increase board breakers, you know, from the starting of the Link format in 2017, I definitely feel the game will be heading in the right direction. For example, with the release of Evenly Matched, for example, you know, you can only activate this card in the battle phase from your hand if you control new cards, and you just get to banish all cards your opponent controls equal to the amount of cards you control. So since it's going to be the only card you control when you activate it, so your opponent can only keep one card on the field. Absolutely fantastic card, and a great card to definitely break those boards. And definitely, you know, since that card's release, it's definitely was really quite expensive. It's still, you know, moderately expensive now. You know, it's not exactly like, you know, ridiculous prices, but it's still, you know, going for a good price. But, you know, apart from that card, and obviously with Raigeki being limited, we didn't really have a lot of board breakers, you know, to help break those boards. I mean, hand traps, you know, are good, obviously, but hand traps, you know, are, and I do feel, in my opinion, are starting to feel power crept, you know, because we are getting stronger and stronger monsters, stronger and stronger cards that can do way more than they could do before. You know, when you have a card like Appaloosa, for example, that is a Link monster that can negate like up to four times. I mean, come on, four times negation? Are you ridiculous? Seriously. Good grief. You know, when you have cards like this as a staple, right, as the norm, then hand traps are really looking a little bit, you know, a little bit weak, I'm sorry to say, right? So definitely things are not looking, you know, we're not looking good for our competitive scene, for our meta game now. Yes, you could play skillfully, but really, if you know a combo deck, you need a board. I mean, if you don't draw something like an evenly matched, you know, then you're just done. But then we got a card like Dark Ruler No More. Now, Dark Ruler No More, we got it at that time, but its effect was, you know, and it still states off like this, if I can just remember, aha, I've got it. You can negate this card, you can activate this card, and negate all monster effects your opponent controls. Your opponent cannot respond to this card's activation with a monster effect. So if they have a field full of monsters, they can't just negate it with a monster effect. Fantastic card. However, when you activate this card, you cannot deal your opponent damage for the rest of the turn. So it basically shuts off, it negates all monsters on your opponent's side of the board, but however, you can't deal them damage this turn. Fantastic card. Now, I'll get back to this card in a moment, but you know, fantastic card, but we never really saw usage with it. Now, it's when, you know, fast forward, you know, to 2020, and now we got a release of Lightning Storm, and oh my goodness, Lightning Storm, absolutely fantastic card that Konami has given us. Great going second card. So let me state its effect. So Lightning Storm's effect is as follows. It's a normal spell that can only be activated if you control no face-up cards. So yay for flip decks, they got support, right? But anyways, let's continue. So you can only activate this card if you control no face-up cards. And when you do, you can decide to choose one of two effects. Either destroy all monsters your opponent controls, or destroy all spells and traps your opponent controls. Fantastic. And now, I'll get back to Dark Ruler No More. So obviously now, fast forward to 2020, and fast forward to the format we're in now, where we have loads, we have a deck that's a combo deck, combo heavy, and are players gravitating to that really helps us in the TCG? Lo and behold, it's Dark Ruler No More. Dark Ruler No More is now becoming a really great card against combo decks and really evening out the situation when you get a combo deck that just relies on monster effects, you know, and doesn't rely on like spells and traps. And it's really showcasing just the how healthy it is and how it is promoting that interaction that we so desperately need in the game right now. It's really, even though it was released last year, it's really showcasing the power and its positive influence in our meta game. Yeah, absolutely fantastic. Now, as you can see, as I've mentioned about, you know, Dark Ruler No More, great card. Lightning Storm, great card. And, you know, we are getting similar cards, you know, in Rise of the Duelist, but, you know, I feel like these cards are a little bit over the top. I mean, you have something like three Tactical Talents, that's three banned cards. You know, I get it. You know, it's going to help in breaking those boards, and it's going to help in just making the game fair and having, you know, an underdog player being able to play against, you know, the competitive deck. But, you know, you have to see it from both sides. Again, Konami wants to promote this card, you know, wants to just make just a great card, you know, that just everyone's going to use. Just get that hype! You know what I mean? Yeah. Unfortunately, things don't work out like that. Because obviously, when you create hype, you know, against a card, when you make a card that has just such a very strong effect, everyone's going to use it, it's going to get abused. And, you know, it's just a whole lot of, just a whole other topic, you know, that is just a whole topic on its own. Anyways, leaving that aside, now, what do I feel about board breakers? Ever since, like, you know, Konami's taken this stance to introduce more board breakers, I think it's been a great help for our meta game and the competitive scene. I'm definitely liking the fact that, you know, with Dark Ruler No More in our game, that you can, it's requiring more skill, and it's forcing that interaction, not just like your opponent just makes some crazy ass board, you know, with monsters, and you can't do anything. But unfortunately, in my opinion, I feel we need more board breakers and we need less negation cards. Because if this is what they're doing right now to our game, making it healthy, then I definitely feel we need more of them. Because it is going to be a staple. We are going to be getting cards that just have negation all the time. I mean, we've got Appaloosa in our game. I mean, for Pete's sake, Appaloosa negate when it's made in the correct manner can negate monster effects up to four times. Four times, mate! Are you serious? Good grief. Right? So we definitely, yeah, we need more board breakers. And it's for that reason why I really feel in the future we could put Regeki to two. Now, hear me out. Yes, Regeki is a card that is a bit unfair, but come on, let's be serious. How many times do we see in our meta games or combo decks right now that have card effect protection? Really? I mean, seriously? You really think like Regeki is an unfair card? No, it's not. I think it would be healthy. You know, it would be another board-breaking card that we need. And one thing I like about board-breaking cards is that they force that interaction. You know, when your opponent definitely has, you know, this combo head centric deck that puts all this negation, and basically a board breaker card just says, you know what, no, behave. You're not just going to just make this silly board and not suffer some consequences. It forces the negations out, and that's really good. You have this back and forth, you know, as I like to call it, interaction. So for example, let's say you know, your opponent makes a silly board, you know, with Adamancipator, and then you activate Dark Room and more. So now they are forced, right, to activate their back row, you know, if they have it, possibly, to negate that card. And if you were to activate Lightning Storm again, they are forced to do something about it because they can't just use their monsters. So what this does is it just destroys plans, a carefully elaborated plan that combo decks have. And, you know, and I feel that's necessary because, you know, a duel is all about, like, interaction between two players. You need to outskill or outmatch your opponent. But your opponent should not be having a perfect setup all the time, every time, without any consequences. I feel that's not right. That's not fair. You know, when you know, you're making a board that has 4 to 5 negations, you know, with multiple back row down there. It's just, that's not fun to face. You know, when, you know, that's equivalent to me just, you know, like, I can just go out here and just stare at this cupboard, right? Does that make for an interesting video? No, I could do that, like, you know, the whole time. But, you know, I'm not going to do that, obviously, because, you know, it's a point that I'm just trying to address. But you see what I'm getting at here. You can't just be looking at a wall for the whole day. Imagine if you took out your, you know, your cards and just stared at a wall, you know, for 30 minutes. Does that sound fun to you? It's not. And so that is equivalent to what combo decks do. What combo decks and all these negation style decks is that they just force your opponent, they're basically just looking at a wall. Because they know that their opponent can't do anything because they've set it up that way. There is no challenge in defeating an opponent who can't even play. You know, where's the challenge in that? You know, there's no challenge in that. There's no interaction. There's nothing there. And so, in my opinion, I feel we need more board-breaking cards. Yeah, definitely, I can, hopefully, you know, fingers crossed, in the future, we could possibly, you know, bring Regeki to 2. Maybe we could get a card in the future, like Banish Hole, you know, a spell version of Evenly Matched, allowing you to just banish all monsters on the field, you know, face down. Can't have that abuse, you know, domestically, obviously. But, you know, stuff like that, you know. It'd really be good. So yeah, what's my overall opinion on board breakers? I feel they're fantastic. You know, we need more of them, and we need less of cards that negate other cards. I mean, less of this negating bullshit. Seriously. And more board breakers. They are healthy. They are fun. and they bring skill into the game. They bring that interaction. They bring those mind games that we need, you know, at the higher competitive level. Definitely fantastic cards. That's all really I've got to say, you know, about, like, you know, board breakers. I mean, sure, there's more to be mentioned here, but I think we can leave it there. Board breakers, overall, all I can say is board breakers are a fantastic addition, you know, to Yu-Gi-Oh! I feel this is the step in going forward in healing the, healing the game and maybe making a better environment in the competitive scene and a better environment in general for Yu-Gi-Oh! I feel there are many other factors that Yu-Gi-Oh! Needs to be, you know, the best of the best, you know, to create a healthy environment all the time. And board breakers are just a small part, or really I would say now a big part in making that ideal Yu-Gi-Oh! Game possible. You know, being able to just have interactions, you know, on a competitive level, being able to allow you, you know, just have both players like constantly, okay, does my opponent have this? Does he have that? You know what I mean? Will he activate Dark Ruler no more? Do I negate it? Is he going to activate Regeki? You know, can I stop it? Because now we're at a stage in Yu-Gi-Oh! I feel that, you know, combo decks are quite strong. They can do a lot of things. You know, it's a very good, you know, majority of decks can spam like 3 to 4 monsters easy like this. If you don't hit them with a hand trap or anything, you know, if it's a good archetype, competent archetype, you know. But even it doesn't have to be a competent archetype. Like, you know, if it's a competent Yu-Gi-Oh! Player, he can, you know, good players can make even like decks that most people consider trash spam out a lot of monsters. So special summoning monsters is not exactly a difficult thing in Yu-Gi-Oh! It really isn't. And with that in mind, you know, making like multiple monsters with negations, again, it's not that difficult. That's why board breakers, I feel, are so healthy and are really required in the state that Yu-Gi-Oh! Is in at the moment, because the game is getting faster and faster and faster, and Konami is printing out more and more cards that do multiple things. I definitely feel like cards like Dragoon are going to be a staple and something that we're going to be seeing more of in the future. Like, I don't like cards like Dragoon, don't get me wrong. They're just absolutely broken. But because, again, Konami is a business, you know, they want to promote the game, they want to give that hype, you know what I'm talking about, yeah? So that's how it is. And with that being said, this is what I've got to say. You are one step closer to becoming a Yu-Gi-Oh! Master. My fate, right, is in your hands. Like and subscribe, hate and subscribe. You could decide to not subscribe at all. The choice is yours. Goodbye.